Now let's look at how a patent application processes through the USPTO. Patent examination is a process by which a patent examiner reviews the contents of a patent application for compliance with U.S. legal requirements. These are the requirements that we have talked about earlier in the presentation. After a thorough examination of the application, the patent examiner comes to a conclusion as to the invention's patentability and decides whether to grant or reject the patent application. All patent examiners at the USPTO have at least a bachelor's degree relative to the subject matter applications that they will be assigned to examine, though many have graduate degrees as well. For example, USPTO patent examiners have degrees in engineering, including electrical, mechanical, and chemical. Biology and microbiology, physics, and design examiners may have degrees in architecture, applied arts, or graphics. Every new examiner receives both on-the-job and formal training, which cover all aspects of basic and advanced examining functions and corresponding legal concepts. And the burden lies first with the patent examiner to prove that the claimed invention fails to comply with one or more of the patentability requirements. The first step is to file an application for a patent, and I want to point out one of the most important changes that the American Invents Act made to the U.S. patent system. That is, the United States switched from being a first-to-invent system to a first-inventor-to-file system. Changing to first-inventor-to-file brought the United States in line with other countries' laws and brought more certainty to the U.S. patent process. All patent applications filed in the United States after March 16, 2013 are filed under the first-inventor-to-file rules. A patent application may be filed either electronically or in paper form. But be aware that the American Invents Act provides for an additional fee for filings made by non-electronic means. The USPTO has a series of informational videos specifically on first inventor to file changes, and these videos, along with others relative to the America Invents Act, can be found on our website at www.uspto.gov. I have also provided the link to the webpage with AIA informational videos at the end of this presentation. Here are the requirements for utility patent application. It must include a written description or specification of the invention. We talked about that requirement earlier. At least one claim, drawings if necessary to understand the invention, an oath or declaration stating, among other things, that the inventor or inventors truly came up with the invention. And for biotechnology inventions, a nucleotide and/or amino acid sequence listing, if necessary. Patent claims define the legal scope of the patent and can be compared to the deed to a house or piece of land. Like a property deed, the claims define the legal boundary between what constitutes a trespass of the property rights, or in the patent world, what is an infringing or non-infringing action. When the application is received at the USPTO, the office will conduct a formalities review of the application and will notify the applicant of any deficiencies found. This is more of an administrative check to ensure all patent application documents have been properly filled out or included. Once the application has passed the formalities review, it is then assigned to an examiner who will evaluate the application based on the patentability requirements we discussed earlier. Once the application is taken up by the patent examiner for examination, the examiner will read the patent application to gain an understanding of the invention and the claims. Next, a search of the prior art begins. These pictures were taken in the early and the mid-20th century, showing how examiners in the U.S. Patent Office used to search for prior art. Before computers changed how we all work, patent searches were done by hand through stacks and stacks of granted patents, and by searching other printed materials such as books, treatises, magazines, and newspapers. Today, patent examiners have access to the latest electronic databases and resources to search for prior art related to the technology of an invention claimed in a patent application, and can perform patent application searches at any location that has computer access to the internet. Once the search is completed, the examiner will prepare a written communication called an office action, indicating the examiner's decisions regarding compliance or noncompliance with the patentability requirements, with supporting reasoning and evidence. If at any point in the process the patent examiner is satisfied that the claimed invention is fully compliant with all legal requirements, the application is allowed to be issued as a patent. If, however, the examiner determines that one or more laws have not been complied with, the examiner will send an office action containing a rejection or rejections to the applicant for response. The applicant must then respond to the patent examiner's rejections. The response can include cancellation of any rejected claims, amendments of those claims to overcome the rejection, arguments that the rejection does not apply, or evidence that calls into question the basis of the rejection. If the examiner is still not convinced by the inventor's response that the rejection should be withdrawn, the examiner may make the rejection final. Does an inventor have any options after receiving a final rejection? The answer is yes. After receiving a final rejection, the inventor has the option to appeal the examiner's decision to the Patent Trial and Appeal Board, or PTAB, for further review. The inventor also has the option to file a request for continued examination, or RCE, to begin another round of examination where the inventor can introduce some additional claim amendments or arguments. And finally, if the inventor does not respond to the final rejection, the patent application will be abandoned and no further action will be taken on it by the USPTO. If the claimed invention is found by the examiner to be fully compliant with all the U.S. patent laws, the application will be allowed and a patent will be granted. Once a patent is granted, the inventor or patent owner has the right to exclude others from exploiting the invention. The patent grant is now an asset that can allow the inventor time to enter and develop a market for the invention, attract investors to risk their capital in financing the commercialization of the invention, or to license the patent to others who seek to develop the technology. Now, this has been a very simplified version of the patent examination process, and in the case of a real patent application, the process could have many more steps and take many months to complete. I hope you now have a good understanding of the basics of patents, what they are, what they protect, and what it takes to get patent protection in the United States. For more detailed information on U.S. patent laws and regulations, the USPTO examination process, the America Invents Act, and resources available from the USPTO for inventors, including the Patent Pro Bono Program, where free legal assistance is available to under-resourced inventors interested in securing patent protection for their inventions, and the Pro Se Assistance Program, where inventors who may not have the resources to hire a patent attorney or agent can get help meeting their goals of protecting their valuable intellectual property, please use the links shown on this slide or visit our website at www.uspto.gov.